Hello everyone, I'm Rob with ScrappyDude.com, and this is just going to be a short little tutorial in Make the Cut, showing you how you can arch warp some text or arch warp some images that you import. Now you can go from this right here to this right here. Now this image that you see right here is from my stepmom. She is a professional cake designer, and she hit me up on the phone and she asked, "Hey Rob, I got this image that I imported into Make the Cut. Is there any way that I can you know, arch it, bow it in the middle?" And I got to thinking about it, and I gave her the answer, and I thought it would make a great video to show everyone on how you can do this with Make the Cut. So let's go ahead and get started. We're going to go ahead and start with what she had. And she basically, you know, she went online. She found the image. She right-clicked, she said copy image, and then she brought it in to Make the Cut via the pixel trace. And she went to the paste button. All right, so right now it's analyzing the image, and then she went to palette, and she went to apply changes. And then she went ahead and imported. All right, so now that we have this on the mat, now it's time to arch it or bow it. And when I first thought about this, I said, well, maybe we can try the Bezier Warp tool. And I tried that first, and it wasn't giving me the desired results, okay? So then I thought, well, there's got to be another way. Let me think about it. And I said, well, let's check out this next tool that's right next to the Bezier Warp tool, which is right here, and it's the conical warp. So I went ahead and clicked that, and there you go. That's how you can do this. It's very easy. So right here, I just said, hey, you know, change the diameter, if you know, depending upon how big you want this bow to be. You can also change the Y offset, bring it down, bring it up. Just depends on how you would like this to look. And then you can go ahead and hit the import. You can decide whether or not you want to bring that cone in. If not, you can toggle it off and hit the import. And there you can see it gave a nice little subtle arched bow in the middle as well as the top. Now, like I said, this doesn't just work with images that you import. It also works with text. So as you can see on this, it arched the text as well. And I can just run through that real quick with you as well. Just add the text group, accept, then go back down there to the conical warp and import. Same thing. See, pretty easy, right? So if you guys have any suggestions on how you would have done this, go ahead and feel free to post in the comments below. And if you know anyone that can use this tutorial, feel free to share this video. So with that, I'm Rob with ScrappyDude.com, and I will see you next time. Thanks for watching.